Gangsta don't dance, two-step with my nigga. Two-step with my nigga. Say gangsta don't dance, two-step with my nigga.
This week, so yeah, as you can see, I got the car back from the shop. I was having a problem with my battery, right, when my car starting. Tried to start it. I know it was because the brake light stayed on, then I fixed that problem, you know, bootleg way. I'm about to go to Rise Ding, get the actual piece if they have any stock, or I got a Honda dealership on Friday. Anyway, so the battery keeps dying. Either I drove it, like I jumped in and drove it for like fucking 30 minutes and it's still dead. So I'm gonna take it to work, put on the charger. So I got like a little battery. I mean, it's probably time to change. I never changed my battery in this car. So I'm gonna get a new battery and I'm gonna charge that one just to see, you know. And then, well, you know, if it's good, it's good. I can fucking drive. I have a backup battery, but not, then we'll put a new battery in there. That's new terminals too, because this negative terminal right here, don't worry, I'm gonna cover these with electrical tape before I close the hood. But so that terminal right there, it's like loose, they're very loose, like I literally could just wiggle them off the terminal. So I know that's bad for connection reasons, you know. So this new terminals as well, install those. Still got that code 16 fuel injection. I can see my new injectors in there. It's my 440cc injectors. So car still in let mode. They tuned it. Oh, I see my last, yeah. They tuned it and it's still fucking tripping. Still has the check engine light, still inlet mode, so it's not really past 35. So I gotta see what's that about. You know, still gotta wash this bitch. So yeah. I'm gonna wipe my engine bay down. I need to get a new transmission bell housing, cause one of my bolts is, so I can see it right here. I think you can see it from underneath the car. Pretty much one of the bolts that holds my transmission is not there because the housing in itself is cracked. So even if I get a bolt, it won't fit in there because it has nowhere to screw. The thing is cracked. So it's my third gear. It's like pretty much the transmission moves, so it grinds third gear all the time. So I'm gonna go on the hunt to see if I can find a transmission this weekend. Fix that problem. I wanna actually buy a new radiator because I don't like how this one looks. So like, I mean, it still works, you know, but I don't like how they sprayed it, so I might just go ahead and get a new one. Order a new radiator. But before then, that's what I wanna buy, but I have to get my car diagnosed and that might cost me a little bit, so I wanna make sure I got some funds, you know, to spend to fix this. As you guys know, I'm not going to their shop no more. I found a new shop. I don't want them to touch my car anymore, bro. Like, on some real shit, like, fuck that. Every time I take my car, it's always some fucking shit. Always some shit, man. Every time I take my car up there, it's always some shit. And I don't like how they leave your car on the street either. If they gotta keep it for a few days, they'll keep that bitch on the street. I don't like that. I feel like anybody could just come and fuck with my car or steal my rims off my car and, oh, we're not liable, because that's what happened when somebody hit my car. Luckily, they had the fucking person's insurance and I got paid for that shit, you know? But
I don't want no shit like that to happen again. And then they'd be like, well, we're not liable for your car.
This is the oil
from all the oil changes I've done on my car. I'm about to take it to work and go dump it out. They let us go recycle it over there, so that's what I'm gonna do. I actually need to clean this car out. But yeah, just a little update up for you guys. Give me a second, I gotta. So yeah, man, just a little update for y'all. Trying to get the tag running right. By episode 100, man, I want my tag to be running right. I will not fucking make another video. I'll have fucking 20 minute videos before my goddamn car not be running right. Like, I'll stop making integrity videos until this fucking car is running right. Like, on some real shit. By episode 100, we should be fucking running mint. And then I can think about boost, you know what I'm saying? Because they said, let me give it a rundown. I was talking to him about boosting it. He said I got to rebuild it, of course, you know? So, I know that's going to cost me like, maybe like $2,000 or something like that to rebuild my car. I started rebuilding myself, of course, you know? And one thing I won't do on that is fucking, I'll probably tell the shop to do it because I have bad experience doing it myself. I want to fuck with the engine. But I gotta rebuild it so I'll be able to handle higher boost. And yeah, and for all my son is sleeping, so I'm gonna wake him up. But for all my Castle B20s, right? Here's the thing. How high can you rev a B20? That is the main question a lot of people ask. We go on the forums and everything. Well, I talked to a guy that works at the shop who's on the Integra for 5 years, boosted for 5 years. And I was like, yeah, like, he's done a lot of builds in that shop. And I was like, how high can I rev a B20? You know what I'm saying? The B20 VTEC, how can I rev it safely? He was like, you can rev it up to 8 grand, but if you want to be safe, just go 7,500 or whatever. I was like, okay, that's cool. It's not bad, because that's past the red line on my odometer anyway, so that's mint as fuck. So just in case y'all wondering how high you can rev a B20 VTEC, it's between 7,500 and 8 grand. That's what you read the line at. So, now you know, because I didn't know. I was going to forums and they were saying like, 65, whatever, all this other shit. I was like, man, what the fuck? Who knows the real answer? So that's the real answer. If you rev that high, make sure your engine is healthy, though. Don't be revving on no fucked up engine. For sure. Damn, I got bit in the ankle. I don't know how I got bit on my ankle. Fuck mosquitoes. But, next video I'll be doing will be the shout out video. And I will be posting the giveaway today on how to enter and all that stuff. So make sure you guys look out for that. That'll be coming out today. And, yeah. Hopefully we get this car running right, y'all, man. We on episode, like, what is this, like 91, 92? I forget. But by episode 100, we will be fucking running right. I'm telling y'all right now, I will not make a video unless my car is going to be fucking running right by episode 100. We can be like, episode 99. That shit ain't running right. We is not making a video until that shit is fucking mint, bro. But, shit, man. That's all I really got for y'all, man. Just pray for me, boy. Pray for Tiffany, man, that we get it right. Oh, the reason why it might be fucked up, I didn't say that. All right, the reason it might be fucked up is they told me it could be electrical, how they connected shit. It could be electrical, or it could be mechanical, how they put it together. If I just let them do a rebuild on it, it's going to cost me a few thousand, like about $2,000, pretty much what I pay at the other shop. And I'm not trying to do that if it's something simple. Or it could be a sensor, they said, because I have a lot of aftermarket sensors. So, and it's not the injectors, because I just got brand new injectors. They said that code 16, even on the OEM ECU, code 16 is fuel injection code. But he said when you put the Haltech in there, it switches the codes around. So code 16 could be something else. So we gotta call Haltech and see what code 16 is. And that should be able to help us more with getting her running right. So just wanna throw that out there. But yeah, that's it, man. Like, hope y'all enjoyed this video. I'll give y'all an update on Tiffany, you know. And yeah. I'm trying to get her running right, man. That is my goal. Before the end of this goddamn, before Christmas, bro, I'm trying to have that car running right. So, yeah. Like, share, subscribe, comment, and I'm out.